Now, question number three is very interesting question. And in this question, we are given a functional equation, which is represented by this relation, which is fx into fy. And it is equal to f 2xy plus 3 plus 3fx plus y minus 3fy plus 6y for all real numbers x and y. Then we need to find the value of f8. Now, what we'll do is in this expression, we'll put x as 0. So we'll put x as 0, we'll get f0 into fy, and this is f3 plus 3fy minus 3fy plus 6y. Now here we can cancel 3fy with 3fy. So from here we can write f0 into fy, and this is equal to f3 plus 6y. Now what we'll also do is in this expression, now we'll put y as 0. So we'll put y as 0, we'll get f0 square, and it'll be equal to f3. Now we'll let value of f0 as some k. So we can write this as kfy, and it'll be equal to k square plus 6y. So this function fy, it will simply be 6y plus k square upon k. Now in order to find the value of f8, we need to find the value of k. Now in this functional relation, if we'll put y as 0, then we can write fx into f0, it'll be f3 plus 3fx minus 3 times f0 plus 6 into 0. Now we have taken f0 as k and f3 as k square. So we can write this fx together. So we can write fx, and this is k minus 3, and it'll be equal to k square minus 3k. So from here we'll get either the value of k is 3 or value of fx is simply k. Now we'll take fx as k. In that case, this function will be a constant function. Now constant function actually doesn't satisfy this condition. So we'll eliminate this condition. So that means from this we can write value of k must be 3. So if value of k is 3, we can simply write fy as 6y plus 9 upon 3. So it'll simply be 2y plus 3. Now we need to find the value of f8. Now f8 is 16 plus 3, and that is 19. So value of f8 is simply 19, and that is the answer to this question.